Ladies and gentlemen, it's the one and only. I just told him before we started recording, I'm like, bro, deep down, there's a fan in me that's going wild. And I'm trying to contain myself. And he's like, I can only imagine how you feel. It's the one and only Adekunle Gold.
Good, brother. What's good? What's good? I'm so happy today, you know. So, yeah, you really caught me at the best time. My energy is up, you know. My music just dropped. I'm really excited for the song because I know it's a banger, you know, and then how people are responding to it, yeah, it makes me happy. So yeah.
But bro, like you have been dropping music for so long, and it's rare that you miss, you know. And and I just want to understand, like, do you still get nervous before you make a release?
Before maybe not anymore now, you know, because if anything, it will be the kind of fear that I will have. It will be, I hope this is the one that should come first. You know, I know also every song that I drop will bang. You know, it's just, does it work for this time? Or, you know, sometimes I just let it go. Like, you know, I don't want to overthink. I just drop whichever one I'm feeling. Yeah.
I love that, man. When you think of this home that you have in the southern part of the continent, like, what comes top of mind when you think of South Africa?
Listen, I think a group of people, you know, that just show love. Every interaction that I've had with a South African has been great, like pure great vibes. You guys go all out. I don't know how you do it, but there's just that aura of, you know, great energy around you. So yeah, I've been like a couple times, and I always love it there. It's so much fun. You know, now I'm beginning to I want to get into, you know, like meeting more people, you know, in the industry, making more friends there. And that's been going very well. You know, like the other day I was speaking to Tyler, I see you.
Nice.
Crazy, crazy guy. And we're working on something. I'm just, it feels good to be connecting with people, you know. We are one people, and then I feel like there's no better time than now to just connect, you know. Yeah.
That is so true, man. And I was telling someone, it's like, I look at the relationship that Nigeria and Ghana have, you know, there's so many collaborations that always come out between those two countries. And
I know.
You know, there was a moment where South Africa and Nigeria, I always say, like, Nigeria and South Africa, we're like long distance brothers and sisters. You
I know.
There's this energy we have.
And sometimes we fight. I mean, Africans fight.
Yeah.
That's it. We fight.
You know, it's like we have this relationship with one another that we, you know, there was this moment where we were working, and then we stopped for a moment, and then amapiano came through.
Now we're coming back.
Yes.
I know.
Do you think we're working enough, though? We collaborating enough?
Oh no, I think we're back.
Yeah.
Like you said, there was one time that I was very high, and then we stopped.
Yeah.
And now everybody's going back. You know, yo, whatever you guys smoke, or whatever you guys smoke when you make amapiano, bro, I want part of it, because that sound is crazy, bro.
True.
I see some things on the news, people saying Afropiano. I'm like, please stop it. There's no such thing. There's only one sound.
Yeah.
And it's amapiano. Either amapiano or nothing else, or something else. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So now I'm really feeling the energy. I mean, South African music has been one of the best, like, from time immemorial, you know, from the legends till the people that are killing it right now, you know. So yeah, it feels good to know that we're back to working together. I'm looking forward to doing more, you know, to more collaborations. The one of the ones that I did that I'm really proud of is the one with Amanda Black, Africa. You know, I think that's a great, crazy tune. I hope people are really feeling out there, you know. Yeah. And just wanna connect with my family over there, you know.
Yeah. You know, I'm gonna stunt a little bit with your stats. You know, for someone listening right now watching this, they probably South African, or they've never heard of you before. I'm like, where have you been living? You dropped this project last year. It was your third studio album, Afro Pop Volume 1. That project is insane, bro. You know, you did 63 million streams. That's on Audio Mac. Your single, OK, dropped that one in November 2020. 6.7 mm-hmm. million views on YouTube, probably more right now.
Yeah, it's now.
You know, insane numbers. 2021, 30th of April, you've been pulling insane numbers also on Audio Mac with 4 million spins, 2 million views on YouTube. Today, you decided to drop a brand new single with Lucky yeah. Days called Sinner. It's insane. Like, the stats are just wild when it comes to your music. What keeps you going, and what would you say is your secret?
You know, I think it's just, I'm a hungry guy, you know. Just wanna, my desire to succeed is embedded in me. I just wanna, because I know where I'm coming from, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah, life, where I'm coming from is crazy, and it's still crazy for many people out there. So I just hope that every day I'm an inspiration to people that it's possible, you know, to just be whatever you want to become, you know. So I guess it's that drive that just keeps me going. I just don't know how to stop. I don't know how to stop. People see me and say, "Rah, like you're succeeded already. Like you're a success already. What's, you know, what's, so why do you keep going?" I don't know. I just like it. I just like, and I guess it's because I like the music that I make so much. I just want to be up on my game and just doing it, just killing it, because there's still so much to offer. So why stop? No.
Yeah. You know, I remember last year I had an opportunity to interview your wife, man, and I was talking about her songwriting ability, and then I'm like, maybe it's something that you guys have together. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, what's your approach to songwriting? And would you say, like, Africa as a continent respects the role of songwriters in Africa?
I mean, my approach to songwriting is simple. It's how it comes. Sometimes I'm in the studio jamming with my band, and then the song comes, you know. Sometimes just jamming with producers, or sometimes I have melodies and I send to my producers, you know, or I make like some la 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 on my phone, send to them, and then write to it. I like to write my experiences. I like to write things that I'm feeling, you know. I like to say things that people don't talk about, you know. So
yeah,
as far as the continent, I feel like, of course, the songs that are big now, they are, the songwriting is top notch, you know. So yeah, it's a thing. You know, like people are really people appreciate like songwriting a lot more now. Yeah.
And when it comes to the sound, you know, people tend to say like R&B or soul music just doesn't really do well in the continent, but you have found a way to bring emotion and soul and purpose and love. You know, like I read
them tell you, anything can work, my brother. Yeah. Anything can work. It's yeah. just It is what it is. Just put your back. Yeah. See what I did there?
Yeah.
It is what it is.
It is. That single is, I've been playing that single this side, man, for a while right now. It's a fire song. And the visuals that you always put out are always top notch. It always feels like there's going to be a second part because it looks like a movie. Like, what's your approach always when it comes to the visuals? Is it a statement? Is it to fulfill the story? Like, just take me through that.
Yes, I'm a storyteller. I just like to tell stories. I like to tell interesting stories, because how else do you interpret like great songs that you've written already?
Yeah.
Like writing, like coming up with like really great story, and that's it. Yeah. Sometimes I have video ideas in my mind while writing a song, so it helps me translate the song better, you know. Yeah.
Love that. Let's talk about the single you just put out today. I think you don't need to release for a while after this one. This Sinner's a banger, bro. Like, Sinner's a banger because we, you know, like, it is what it is. Fire record. You know, just when we were, you know, getting, you know, into our vibes with what it is, you drop Sinner. Take me through this record.
I was in LA and I was thinking about, I've always had this thing at the back of my mind, you know, I want to write. I always thought about, I know it sounds weird, but I always thought about the story of King David and Bathsheba. I don't know if you ever read the Bible or know the Bible story, right? The story of King David, you know, having an affair with Bathsheba, you know. And I thought about it like weirdly, right? Like Bathsheba must be really hot, you know. She must be really fine.
Yeah.
I mean, an African woman, you know. Like, so I just say, you know, I want to talk about this one day. I want to put it in a song. I thought it would make a beautiful story to talk about. The sex, you know, the intimacy and everything, yeah. And that's what brought about the song. Nothing more, nothing deeper than that.
Yeah. And you and Lucky Day, how did you connect?
oh, I wrote the song and I was thinking, you know, I feel like I need another voice on the song. Who else can kill it for me? Right. Lucky day. I came up and then I reached out to him. He's been very good. Like, he's been so supportive. Shout out to him.
Yeah. You know, before I let you go, bro, talent searches are a thing that a lot of people, you know, enter. And here in South Africa, I've seen a few people win idols, but after the competition, I don't see them ever again. What would you say is a secret to keeping your name relevant and riding on the momentum of a talent platform?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't even get far in the talent platform, so I can't even say.
Yeah,
you know, like I didn't make it past the audition stage. But I guess reality shows is different. The reality is now, it's another reality. You know, yeah, you can get all the love on the show, but then what happens when you get outside? I hope your songwriting is top notch. You know, I hope your showmanship is even way greater than what you did out there in the house. You know what I mean? So it's not a lot. It's not enough to just be famous on a show. It takes a whole lot of grind.
Yeah,
it takes years, and we've seen it. Look at Chike, for example. He didn't win The Voice. Yeah, but I mean, a guy just kept going in, and finally he's popping now, you know. So
yeah,
it's amount of dedication and commitment, and I feel like that's really it. You just don't stop. You get a lot of nose resistance, but just don't stop.
Yeah, see, I got the whole country listening to you right now. Which artist in South Africa would you like to get into the lab with?
Listen, I have a long list.
Please, they listening. Trust me, they listening.
No, but you know, one person that I would really love to work with is Nasty C.
Yeah,
I think is by far the coldest rapper I've heard in recent.
Shout out one time, man. That's the one and only Adekunle Gold.